Today we have an old car alternator. It is a Magneti Marelli model A127IR85A, which can deliver up to 85 amps and 14 volts DC. It was apparently produced in the 43rd week of 1996 in Italy. While contemplating this unit, I heard a voice inside my head that said,
"Take it apart."
Well, I removed all the nuts and washers and unsoldered the stator terminals. The housing breaks in two pieces like that. We remove the pulley and voila, the rotor. The rotor is just a multi-pole electromagnet. You can see its coil in there, whose terminals are connected to these two copper slip rings. The coil has a core made of iron with extensions in an interlocked finger-like arrangement, which make its various magnetic poles, in this case 12. The coil is apparently powered by direct current, because the core does not seem to be laminated. This rotating magnetic field inside the stator is what induces alternated voltages, hence the name alternator, at its three coils arranged at an angle of 120 degrees from each other around the circumference. And here you find their terminals connected in pairs, which indicates a delta configuration. It is no different in principle from a three-phase generator that you can find in a power plant. But alternating voltages are of no use here, since all the electronics of a car are powered by DC. That's why we have the other half of the alternator, which houses the rectifier bridge. Here you have a filtering capacitor to smooth out the ripple. You have a voltage regulator, which happens to be an integrated circuit. It does that by sensing the output voltage and controlling the rotor current. The rotor current and speed is what defines the output voltage. Since the alternator is powered by the engine's crankshaft, which rotates at different speeds, the voltage regulator becomes an essential part of the alternator design. This comes out like that, and the three terminals of the stator come through these holes here. The rectifier bridge have six diodes arranged like this schematic. They are press-fitted against these aluminium plates, which act as the negative terminal and positive terminals, and also as heat sinks. There is a terminal here, connected to one of the phase terminals, and it is used by the voltage regulator chip to sense the presence of the alternating voltage at the stator coils. The cast aluminium housing acts as a heat sink also, and is the negative terminal for the whole alternator. This voltage regulator chip is an L913, produced in Malta in 1996 by SGS Thompson. This is the positive terminal. This is the negative. Here we have the plus B terminal, which is traditionally connected to the ignition light in series with the ignition switch. And up there you have the phase sensing terminal. The capacitor, made of some plastic film probably, is rated at 2.2 microfarad 60 volts DC, made by an unidentifiable company in the 7th month of 96 for Marelli Altronica. These are the integrated brushes, which are connected to the slip rings by spring action. The ring to the right is connected directly to the positive output through the corresponding brush. And the ring to the left is connected to the current sink in the voltage regulator chip. I could not find any information about the voltage regulator chip using the L913 part number, but I reckon we can put together the following schematic diagram. So unfortunately, this bridge seems to be a little bit toast. One of its diodes has been converted into a short circuit. You can see that the other diodes are working properly, but this monkey's gone to heaven. So I ordered a generic replacement bridge from the usual suspects. Let's now test the other components. The rotor coil is apparently okay, exhibiting about 2.6 ohms. The stator coils show a very low resistance, which means they are not open, but if there is a shorted turn, we will only know if we power both the rotor with current and make it rotate inside the stator. Guess what? The integrated brush disintegrated. Though you can find replacement brushes, this one is spot welded. Luckily, I have another used voltage regulator lying around, which I think is compatible with this alternator. An SGS Thompson for Denso L9106, produced in 2004 in again the picturesque Malta. At least it fits perfectly in place. I will later order a brand new one. But for now let's use this one because I am curious to see how this thing works. The new rectifier bridge is already installed. The stator terminals are already soldered and we are going to power his thing and connect the oscilloscope to these terminals and see what happens. Thanks for watching. Have a good night and stay beautiful.